boys all stood around the bar and drank their liquor down. It was at O'Connell's pub one night in Campbelltown, when suddenly John Polly came rushing through the door. I've seen a ghost, Fred Fisher's ghost, to all his mates he swore. Fred Fisher had just disappeared in this could mean foul play. No one knew where he had gone or why he went away. And all the boys were silent as Polly told his tale, how Fisher's ghost had stood there leaning on the old stone rail. He stood and pointed to the creek, said Polly with alarm. Pointed to the creek that runs below Fred Fisher's farm. I could see right through him as down the track I fled. I tell you, boys, I've seen his ghost. Fred Fisher must be dead. The story of Fred Fisher's ghost soon spread around the town. And in the dusty street next day, the people gathered round. Then young Trooper Leland to Fisher's place did go. And with him went Black Trackers, Jackie Gilbert, and JoJo. John Farley took them to the spot where Fisher's ghost had stood. Tracker Jackie Gilbert said, I smell a white man's blood. And then the trooper Leland knew he was on the trail, for he had found a smear of blood upon the old slip rail. The two black trackers searched around to see what they could find. Then they went down to the creek with Leland close behind. Gilbert and old JoJo saw marks upon the ground that led them to Fred Fisher's grave beneath the marshy mound. The police found out why Fisher died and how he met his end, and they arrested George Worrell, though he'd been Fisher's friend. When Worrell faced the hangman, a guilty man was he, and he confessed before he died upon the gallows tree. So if you go to Fisher's farm a certain night each year, people up in Campbelltown say Fisher will appear. You'll see his ghost at midnight when eerie shadows creep, just leaning on the old slip rail and pointing to the